Then they had me on there. So I had a busy day yesterday. Had to go to a funeral in Mississippi. Then had to go to sleep to the Blaze Church. Blaze House, excuse me. And then they was having a family prayer at my grandparents, my aunt's house. I wasn't able to get there. So when I got home and laid down for a while, I said, well, took me a shower. I said, well, I know I ain't getting out now, but I took me a shower. Laid down about a couple hours. Just kept bothering me to go over there and see what they were talking about. And when I got over there, you know, them fellas was bucking. They were jumping. They had the strobe light on. And I said, let me just keep my head in the door. I think the Lord already told me he'll get to go over there. And one person walked up and said, hey, Rev, how you doing? Glad you made it. I said, I thought you told me this was a kind of like a class reunion. Yeah. Oh, man, this is so-and-so birthday party. We can now here. Let me tell you something, people are still stuck in time. Amen. And devil want, sometimes he wants you to go back when he try to wake up some of them sleeping demons.
Help us, Lord.
But tell you that, don't go back.
Don't go back. Thank you, Lord.
Wait on your time. God has a set time in our life. Amen. So you can't look at what you're doing through other people. He wants to use us in the time that he has set for us. Young people, don't get discouraged when look like things are not working out like you want them to work out. Stay with God.
Amen.
Stay in school.
Yes.
And if first you don't succeed, do like the old folks said, try and try again. Sometimes people are struggling with the flesh, but you can't give up and throw in the towel. You got to keep on trying until you become an overcomer. Amen. God uses set times. Psalms 102 and 13 says, thou shalt arise and have mercy upon Zion, for time to favor her. Yea, the set time is come. Listen, God got a set time for the church. The church going through some transitions, y'all. But don't jump ship and leave the church. God got a set time when he's going to arrive and have mercy upon Zion. Glory to God. He sees where the church is, because he said the gates of hell shall not prevail against the church.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
If a thing be of God, who can hinder? Who can stop? If you're a child of God, who can hinder you? Who can stop? I often think about a person that always persecutes somebody. Every time you talk about them, you make them worse. Amen. Every time you lie on them, every time their name comes on your tongue in disrespect or disregard, you make that person break. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
So I'll tell you, somebody once, he said, man, I don't know why people do me the way they do. I don't know why they talk about me the way they talk about me. It's because you're important in the eyes of God. Anybody feel like you're important to me? God got a set time in your life. And he wants you to understand what's happening in your life. Come on, so neighbor, hold on to God.
Neighbor, hold on to God.
You got a set time.
You got a set time.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Psalms 18 and 1 said, God got a time set when he will arise. Excuse me, 16 and 1. And then the psalmist said, let God arise and his enemies be scattered. Sometimes you got to let God do what you want to do. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
You heard the preacher say over there at the funeral yesterday. He quoted the scripture, I believe, in Revelation 3 and 21. He said, behold, I stand at the door of knock. If any man open, I'll come in. Come on, say, neighbor, you got to let him in.
Thank you, Lord.
But we're living in times now where people are frustrated. They don't understand why I'm going through this. Why is this happening to me? God wants you to be able to understand the times that we're living in. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
God uses all those seasons and all those times. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
For your redemptive purpose. Glory to God.
Glory to God.
Your time is in God's hand.
Amen.
It's what it says in Psalm 31 and 15. My time.
My time.
In God's hand.
Thank you,
Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Glory to God. Come on, shout it in. My time.
My time.
In God's hand.
It's in God's hand.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
In the first times of Israel, none of them understood the time. And what God was working in. If you have known Saul, you can have first hand. Thank the Lord. So be not Lord. Get ready to choose another man. A man after his own heart. Nobody understood what God was doing. From the tribe of Issachar. Can you say it again? God is looking for somebody. So don't jump ship. For what we have said. Can we say amen? Can you understand that God is in control? Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
God will be ready to set up his throne. Keep it king by men, by men, and king by. Can we say amen?
Yeah.
A little shepherd, Lord. That will have to watch the sheep. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Remember last Sunday I told you. Can we say amen?
Hallelujah.
and an understanding of what God was doing, what God was achieving. But the 12, the other 11 tribes, and you always brought that into a boundary, worshiping idol God. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
I tell you, God bless you. Don't let it come to life. Glory to God.
Glory.
Lady, they're doing our parking lot. They had us on a funeral yesterday.